Hepatitis C is a highly contagious liver disease that can be fatal. Left untreated, it can lead to liver cirrhosis, liver cancer, and other serious liver damage. The hepatitis C virus is usually spread when someone comes into contact with blood from an infected person. Sharing needles or other drug-related materials with someone who has hepatitis C virus is the most common method by which the virus is spread in the United States. Having a tattoo or piercing done with instruments that haven't been disinfected after being used on someone with hepatitis C virus. Having unprotected sex with someone who has hepatitis C virus. Being born to a mother with hepatitis C virus. Approximately 6% of infants born to infected mothers will get hepatitis C. Sharing personal care items, such as razors, toothbrushes, or glucose monitors that may have been exposed to another person's blood. Coming into contact with the blood or open sores of someone who has hepatitis C virus. Getting an accidental stick with a needle that was used on someone who has hepatitis C virus. This can happen in healthcare settings. Blood transfusions and organ transplants. The risk of transmission to recipients of blood or blood products is extremely low due to widespread screening of the blood supply in recent times. It is very important to note that hepatitis C is not spread by sharing eating utensils, hugging, holding hands, breastfeeding, sneezing, or coughing. It also cannot be transmitted by food or water. There are no known cases of hepatitis C virus being spread through kissing. Though, it is possible that hepatitis C virus could be transmitted through kissing if one partner has mouth sores, bleeding gums, or any other condition that could permit blood-to-blood contact. Who is at risk for hepatitis C? Intravenous drug users. People with tattoos. Prisoners or people in closed settings. People with a sexual partner infected with hepatitis C virus. And a child whose mother is infected. Those who have been on long-term kidney dialysis. Viral hepatitis can develop without showing any clinical signs or symptoms, or it might show up with non-specific symptoms with or without jaundice for a brief period of time. These signs and symptoms might range from non-specific flu-like symptoms to fatal liver failure. Some individuals develop a serum-type sickness early in the disease process, which might include fever, arthralgia, rash, and anginerotic edema. The clinical features of hepatitis C depend on the stage of illness. We'll look at each of this stage individually. And we'll begin with signs and symptoms of acute hepatitis. Acute hepatitis C is usually mild and often subclinical, meaning it goes unnoticed by the patient. Acute liver failure or fulminant hepatitis rarely happens in acute hepatitis C. Most people with acute hepatitis C do not develop symptoms. For those who develop symptoms, the incubation period for hepatitis C after exposure is about 7 weeks on average, ranging from 2 to 26 weeks. Symptoms of acute hepatitis C include fever, fatigue, decreased appetite, nausea and vomiting, abdominal pain, dark urine, gray-colored feces, joint pain, and jaundice. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, over half of persons who have acute hepatitis C eliminate the virus from their bodies without treatment and do not develop the chronic disease. The transition from acute to chronic hepatitis C is usually undetectable. The condition slowly develops over many years. Cirrhosis develops in 10 to 20% of people within 20 years. Usually, it is discovered during a routine blood test or a screening for blood donation. Symptoms of chronic hepatitis C include fatigue or malaise. Other patients may have features of chronic liver disease like anorexia, nausea, right upper quadrant pain, dark urine, and pruritus. Decompensated cirrhosis is another stage of hepatitis C infection we'll look at. The term decompensated cirrhosis refers to the liver's inability to perform its usual functions. Ascites, encephalopathy, jaundice, coagulopathy, and GI bleeding are all symptoms of this condition. Acute hepatitis C is a short-term infection following incubation period. Majority are asymptomatic, meaning they do not show any symptoms. Symptoms of acute hepatitis last up to 6 months. After that, some people who have it will get rid of, or clear, the virus on their own. However, when the body cannot clear the virus, acute infections become chronic in more than 50% of the cases. Chronic hepatitis C is a long-term infection lasting longer than 6 months. Over the course of 20 to 30 years, 10 to 20% will develop liver cirrhosis and hepatocellular carcinoma. How is hepatitis C diagnosed? Screening for hepatitis C using anti-HCV antibodies is important because many patients remain undiagnosed as the condition is largely asymptomatic until complications develop. Because many people with hepatitis C don't show any symptoms, they're only diagnosed when their liver enzymes tests are abnormal, like alanine transaminase or aspartate aminotransferase. These liver enzymes are at times part of routine blood work. The diagnosis of both acute and chronic hepatitis C is based on anti-HCV antibody and serum HCV RNA levels. First, the doctor performs a simple blood test to look for hepatitis C antibodies in the blood. Anti-HCV antibodies are proteins your body makes when it finds the hepatitis C virus in your blood. They usually show up about 12 weeks after infection. Usually, it takes a few days for the results to be out, or even it can be out in a matter of hours through rapid tests. The results can be reactive or positive, meaning you have hepatitis C antibodies and you've been infected. When your test turns out positive, you'll need another test called hepatitis C RNA to confirm. Hepatitis C RNA measures the number of viral RNA genetic material from the hepatitis virus particles in your blood. They usually show up 1 to 2 weeks after you're infected. Your results can turn out to be non-reactive or negative, meaning you don't have hepatitis C. However, if you've been exposed in the last 6 months, you'll need to be retested. The other tests that can be done is liver function tests. This measures proteins and enzyme levels, which usually rise 7 to 8 weeks after you're infected. It's possible to have normal enzyme levels and still have hepatitis C. Another test called a genotype test can determine which type of hepatitis C virus is present. Hepatitis C can be cured. Treatments are available that can cure most people with hepatitis C in 8 to 12 weeks. Direct-acting antiviral medicines can cure most cases of chronic hepatitis C and acute hepatitis C. These drugs act by disrupting viral cell reproduction by targeting particular phases in the HCV life cycle. The choice of medication and duration of treatment depends on the genotype of the virus. The medications available now are elbisvir-grazoprevir. The condition has been cured in as many as 97% of patients who have taken this once-daily medication. Glecaprevir-pibrentasvir. Adult patients with all forms of HCV who do not have cirrhosis and have not previously been treated can take this daily pill for a shorter treatment cycle of 8 weeks. This medicine's recommended dosage is 3 pills per day. Letopasvir-sofosbuvir. In most patients, this once-daily medication cures the illness in 8 to 12 weeks. Other drugs used include Vicurapac, Tecnavi, sofosbuvir with elbisvir or grazoprevir, Epclusa, and Vosvi. The side effects of this hepatitis C drugs includes flu-like symptoms, rash, fatigue, hair loss, headache, nervousness, and depression. Left untreated, chronic hepatitis C can lead to serious health complications that include chronic liver disease, cirrhosis or liver scarring, liver failure, and liver cancer. Early diagnosis and treatment can prevent liver damage. There is no vaccination to prevent hepatitis C infection, but there are strategies to lower the risk of infection. And these are: avoid sharing or reusing needles, syringes, or any other equipment used to prepare and inject drugs, steroids, hormones, or other substances. Screening of blood donors and screening for presence of HCV before transfusion of blood. Do not get tattoos or body piercings from an unlicensed facility or in an informal setting. Make sure any tattooist or piercer uses sterile tools and unopened ink. Avoiding sharing items such as toothbrushes, razors, and nail clippers. Wearing gloves when touching another person's open sores. Informing any new sexual partners about hepatitis C and using barrier protection during sexual activity are two important steps to take. And that is all for this video. If this video has been helpful, hit the like button, share it, and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching. Until next time.